41. The Stimulus Lighthouse Alert Community Presents, the mini biography of Ruth Bader Ginsburg, 1933-2020. Ruth Bader Ginsburg was a U.S. Supreme Court Justice, the second lady to be selected to the position. Who was Ruth Bader Ginsburg? Ruth Bader Ginsburg finished from Columbia Law School, going on to end up being a strong courtroom advocate for the reasonable treatment of women and dealing with the ACLU's Women's Rights Project. She was selected by President Jimmy Carter to the U.S. Court of Appeals in 1980 and appointed to the Supreme Court by President Bill Clinton in 1993. Early life and education. Ginsburg was born Joan Ruth Bader on March 15, 1933, in Brooklyn, New York. The second daughter of Nathan and Celia Bader, she grew up in a low-income, working-class community in Brooklyn. Ginsburg's mom, who was a significant impact in her life, taught her the worth of self-reliance and a great education. Celia herself did not participate in college, but rather worked in a garment factory to assist pay for her brother's college education, an act of selflessness that permanently satisfied Ginsburg. At James Madison High School in Brooklyn, Ginsburg worked vigilantly and excelled in her studies. Unfortunately, her mom dealt with cancer throughout Ginsburg's high school years and died the day prior to Ginsburg's graduation. Personal life and husband. Ginsburg made her bachelor's degree in federal government from Cornell University in 1954, finishing first in her class. She married law student Martin D. Ginsburg that very same year. The early years of their marital relationship were tough, as their first child, Jane, was born soon after Martin was drafted into the military in 1954. He served for 2 years and, after his discharge, the couple returned to Harvard, where Ginsburg likewise enrolled. At Harvard, Ginsburg discovered to balance life as a mother and her new function as a law student. She likewise came across an extremely male-dominated, hostile environment, with only 8 other females in her class of more than 500. The women were chided by the law school's dean for filling in certified males. But Ginsburg continued and excelled academically, ultimately becoming the very first female member of the distinguished Harvard Law Review. Arguing for gender equality. Then, another challenge, Martin contracted testicular cancer in 1956, requiring intensive treatment and rehabilitation. Ginsburg addressed her young child and convalescing other half, keeping in mind for him in classes while she continued her own law studies. Martin recovered, graduated from law school, and accepted a position at a New York law office. To join her husband in New York City, Ginsburg moved to Columbia Law School, where she was chosen to the school's law review. She finished first in her class in 1959. In spite of her outstanding academic record, however, Ginsburg continued to encounter gender discrimination while seeking work after graduation. After clerking for U.S. District Judge Edmund L. Palmieri, 1959-61, Ginsburg taught at Rutgers University Law School, 1963-72, and at Columbia, 1972-80, where she became the school's very first female tenured professor. Throughout the 1970s, she also acted as the director of the Women's Rights Project of the American Civil Liberties Union, for which she argued 6 landmark cases on gender equality prior to the U.S. Supreme Court. However, Ginsburg also believed that the law was gender blind and all groups were entitled to equal rights. One of the 5 cases she won before the Supreme Court included a portion of the Social Security Act that favored women over males since it gave particular benefits to widows but not widowers. On the Supreme Court. In 1980, President Carter appointed Ginsburg to the U.S. Court of Appeals for the District of Columbia. She served there until she was selected to the U.S. Supreme Court in 1993 by President Clinton, picked to fill the seat left by Justice Byron White. President Clinton desired a replacement with the intellect and political abilities to deal with the more conservative members of the court. The Senate Judiciary Committee hearings were abnormally friendly, in spite of disappointment expressed by some senators over Ginsburg's evasive responses to theoretical situations. Several expressed issue over how she might shift from social advocate to Supreme Court justice. In the end, she was easily confirmed by the Senate, 96-3. As a judge, Ginsburg favored caution, small amounts and restraint. She was considered part of the Supreme Court's moderate liberal bloc, presenting a strong voice in favor of gender equality, the rights of employees and the separation of church and state. In 1996, Ginsburg composed the Supreme Court's landmark decision in United States v. Virginia, which held that the state-supported Virginia Military Institute could not decline to admit women. In 1999, she won the American Bar Association's Thurgood Marshall Award for her contributions to gender equality and civil rights, Bush v. Gore. Regardless of her credibility for restrained writing, she collected significant attention for her dissenting viewpoint when it comes to Bush v. Gore, which successfully chose the 2000 presidential election in between George W. Bush and Al Gore. Challenging the court's bulk viewpoint favoring Bush, Ginsburg deliberately and subtly concluded her choice with the words, "I dissent," a substantial departure from the tradition of consisting of the adverb respectfully. On June 27, 2010, Ginsburg's spouse died of cancer. She explained, "Martin is her most significant booster and the only young man I dated who cared that I had a brain." Married for 56 years, the relationship between Ginsburg and Martin was said to vary from the norm. Martin was gregarious, enjoyed to entertain and tell jokes, while Ginsburg was severe, soft-spoken and shy. Martin offered a factor for their successful union: "My other half does not provide me any suggestions about cooking, and I don't give her any suggestions about the law." A day after her other half's death, she was at work on the court for the last day of the 2010 term. Historic rulings. In 2015, Ginsburg sided with the bulk in two landmark Supreme Court rulings. On June 25, she was one of the six justices to support a critical part of the 2010 Affordable Care Act, often described as Obamacare, in King v. Burwell. The decision permits the federal government to continue supplying subsidies to Americans who purchase health care through exchanges, regardless of whether they are state or federally operated. The majority judgment, checked out by Chief Justice John Roberts, was a huge victory for President Barack Obama and made the Affordable Care Act difficult to reverse. Conservative Justices Clarence Thomas, Samuel Alito and Antonin Scalia remained in dissent, with Scalia providing a scathing dissenting viewpoint to the court. On June 26, the Supreme Court beat far its second historical choice in as many days, with a 5-4 bulk ruling in Obergefell v. Hodges that made same-sex marriage legal in all 50 states. Ginsburg is thought about to have been instrumental in the decision, having shown public assistance for the concept in past years by officiating same-sex marital relationships and by challenging arguments versus it during the early procedures of the case. She was joined in the majority by Justices Anthony Kennedy, Stephen Breyer, Sonia Sotomayor, and Elena Kagan, with Roberts checking out the dissenting opinion this time. Current years. Ginsburg notably opposed the potential of a Donald Trump presidency in 2016, at one point calling him a faker, prior to excusing openly discussing the project. In January 2018, after the president released a list of Supreme Court candidates in preparation for the looming retirement of senior justices, the 84-year-old Ginsburg indicated she wasn't going anywhere by working with a complete slate of clerks through 2020. The issue of her staying power loomed big later in the year when Justice Kennedy, who typically agreed the court's liberal bloc, announced he was stepping down at the end of July, though Ginsburg at that time exposed that she wanted to remain for at least 5 more years. Schedule an RBG movie. In 2016, Ginsburg released My Own Words, a memoir filled with her works that date as far back as her junior high years. The book ended up being a New York Times bestseller. In January 2018, Ginsburg appeared at the Sundance Film Festival to accompany the best of the documentary RBG. Touching on the hashtag MeToo movement, she remembered an earlier time when she needed to endure the advances of a Cornell University teacher. She likewise offered her seal of approval for Kate McKinnon's sassy portrayal of her on Saturday Night Live, noting, "I wish to state Ginsburg in some cases to my coworkers." In an interview with Poppy Harlow at Columbia University in February, Ginsburg expanded on her thoughts concerning the hashtag MeToo motion, stating its remaining power would enable it to endure a reaction. She also defended the value of a complimentary press and an independent judiciary, both of which had actually been challenged during the Trump administration. In April 2018, Ginsburg notched another career turning point by assigning a bulk viewpoint for the very first time in her 25 years with the court. The judgment for Sessions v. DiMaia, which drew attention for conservative Neil Gorsuch's choice to vote with his liberal associates, struck down an arrangement of the Immigration and Nationality Act that allowed the deportation of any foreign national convicted of a crime of violence. Holding seniority among the bulk, Ginsburg eventually assigned the job of penning the viewpoint to Elena Kagan. Health. Ginsburg endured several health scares after being selected to the bench, undergoing surgery for colon cancer, pancreatic cancer and lung cancer. She was hospitalized in November 2018 after falling in her office and fracturing 3 ribs. In May 2020, one day after the court heard arguments via teleconference for the very first time due to the coronavirus pandemic, it was revealed that the senior justice had once again been hospitalized to go through a non-surgical treatment for a gallbladder infection. In July 2020, Ginsburg exposed she was going through chemotherapy for a reoccurrence of cancer on her liver and was yielding favorable results. Death. Ginsburg died on September 18, 2020, at her home in Washington, D.C., from issues of metastatic pancreatic cancer. Our country has actually lost a jurist of historical stature, Roberts stated in a statement. We at the Supreme Court have lost a treasured colleague. Today we grieve, however, with self-confidence that future generations will keep in mind Ruth Bader Ginsburg as we understood her a determined and undaunted champion of justice. Ginsburg laid in state in the Capitol on September 25. She will be the first female and second Supreme Court justice to have this honor. Ginsburg likewise laid in repose at the Supreme Court on September 23 and 24.